What is up, it's Mikey. Let's talk about Firebreak and his hero gear. You must first complete all specialist basic gear challenges, okay? We've already talked about some of the other hero gear. I will have links to those down below, Prophet, Reaper, Battery. You can check those out later, but first let's get into Firebreak's hero head, and you must kill 6 enemies with the purifier in a single game. You must do this 6 times. So, 2 ways to go about this. There is good old hardpoint, because the game mode lasts quite a long time. You can have lots of chances at doing this. Or what I found easier was good old Nuketown, aka the Chaos Mosh Pit. Pretty much Nuketown gets voted on 50% of the time, probably more actually. So let's get into the Nuketown class. That was the easiest for me. You have to be really aggressive. Get a good gun. I like the Razorback. Got extended mag. Black Cell as usual for taking down air support just so we can get easy score. Same thing with the EMP. EMP can stun people, takes down their HUD, and can also take out equipment. Standard issue overclock. We want that to get to our specialist ability faster. Fast Hands helps you ready up faster. Really good for Nuketown. Standard issue for Nuketown. Tactical Mask. Gotta have it. So many random stuns. And I just happen to like awareness. It helps me a lot, especially when you're creeping around in the enemy house. And speaking of which, that's pretty much the playstyle. Once you've made sure the house is clear, just go for broke, go on a suicide mission. And a lot of the times I literally jump into the enemy spawn and just spin around, go crazy, suicide mission, and you're gonna get probably 3 kills or so, maybe a quad if you can. That's the best outcome. But really, 2 or 3 is normal. And remember, if you're playing domination, you must get all 6 kills in a single round. So if you're not that aggressive and you don't like Nuketown, that's why playing hardpoint is better, because you have all that time to do it. Whereas Nuketown domination, which a lot of people vote for, you gotta get all 6 of those kills in a single round. Okay, that's not for everybody. So regular good old hardpoint is good, and here's the class I'll use for that. So there's just a few changes. Ghost, because you want to flank around, and since we're flanking, gotta have hardwired. What's the point in flanking if you're just gonna pop up on someone's 6th sense perk? Okay, gotta have hardwired. Tactical Mask is good if you're getting those hardpoint kills. Maybe you want to have dead silence, that could work too. Engineer is always good for taking down air support, and there's 2 ways you can play hardpoint. You can just bum rush in there, jump on in and just go crazy, sort of like the Nuketown way, or you can flank all the way around, and that's why Ghost and Hardwired is so useful in that way, so that way you don't pop up on the UAV. I thought it would be easier, but actually isn't, because if you die midway using your flamethrower, you're gonna lose all that specialist ability, okay? So this may take you quite a few tries. So try the Nuketown method. If that doesn't work, try the good old hardpoint method. All right, next up, the hero body. Kill 4 enemies stunned by your heat wave in a single game. Gotta do that 4 times, I believe. So easy. I mean, I was able to get up to 8 at one point in a single game. So really easy. Don't stress about this one. Set up any submachine gun you like. AR, really. Just put something with the suppressor on there. Got the Razorback with suppressor and extendos. Overclock, standard issue for pretty much all these hero challenges. We got Ghost because flanking is the name of the game. And we got Hardwired because if you're going to be flanking, last thing you want to do is pop up. And I do recommend dead silence, because with the heat wave, you pretty much super stun them and you got to get up close personal with them, right? So dead silence, don't want to stomp your feet. Tactical Mask is pretty much good for hard points, and basically you want to be aggressive, be really aggressive to get those hard point kills. Don't overpower the other team too much. You want to get a close game so that way it lasts a long time. You get more chances at getting your heat wave kills. So you can play 2 ways. You can bum rush the enemy spawn. Maybe you'll get a double kill. But really the easiest way is just to flank all the way around. Take advantage of using Ghost and Hardwired, dead silence, and I mean, all you gotta do is get 4 kills. This is very, very easy. And like I said, using this setup, I was able to get 8 of them in a single game. I believe I did that 1 or 2 times. Nothing to stress over. And as I said, I will have links down below to all the previous hero gear. What hero gear do you want me to do next? Just leave a comment below and I will get to work on that. By the way, if you appreciate this video, please take 3 seconds to leave a like. It really helps support the channel. If you want to play with me, open lobby, hobbies, contests, updates, all that stuff, I post it on my Twitter or Facebook, links down below, and I will see you next time. All right, so on the left side there, we have more Black Ops 3 tips, tricks, info, updates, all sorts of stuff. It's a playlist. Try to keep that updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below. And on the right side there, we have Destiny tips, tricks, info. It's a playlist. Try to keep that one updated for you. You can click on the screen or links down below.